हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट द ट्यूबरक्यूलर पेरिकार्डाइटिस। ट्यूबरक्यूलर पेरिकार्डाइटिस, ओके, द मोस्ट कॉमन एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस। नॉर्मली ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस मेनली अफेक्ट्स द लंग्स, बट इफ इट वॉज आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस, इट इज़ लिम्फ नोड्स। इवन इन द लिम्फ नोड्स, सर्वाइकल लिम्फ नोड्स आर मोस्ट कॉमन, एंड दिस सर्वाइकल लिम्फ नोड्स इज कॉल्ड हैज गोन्स फोकस। ओके, सो व्हाट आर द क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ ट्यूबरक्यूलर पेरिकार्डाइटिस? इट लुक्स लाइक एनी अदर क्लिनिकल फीचर्स, लाइक द पेशेंट हियर सफर्स फ्रॉम chest pain which is seen at rest, and he also has night sweats because of increased fever. There will be low grade fever which is low grade fever is present, and there is loss of weight, and especially this loss of weight is almost, there will be decrease in 5% of weight over 6 months is seen. And on examination, if you examine it, it is a pericarditis. So on auscultation, you will find the presence of pericardial friction rub. This pericardial friction rub occurs due to the presence of inflammation between the layers of the heart. And here, this pericarditis, which is present in tuberculosis, is serofibrinous exudate is present. And this pericardial friction rub will persist on holding the breath. On holding the breath, this pericardial friction rub will persist. Normally, the pleural rub which we see, that will not persist by holding breath. But pericardial friction rub will persist. So that is how you will differentiate. So if you see a pleural rub in pleuritis or pleural effusion, this will increase or best heard in inspiration. So this is the best method to differentiate between the pleural rub and the pericardial rub. So if you see the ECG findings, on ECG you will find this pattern. Okay, this is the T wave, and you can P wave, Q, RS. Here you have this saddle type ST segment elevation is seen. So if you see here, this is ST segment elevation is seen, which is concave upwards. Okay, this is seen in pericarditis. Okay, this is pericarditis. Very good. But if you remember, even MI is associated with ST segment elevation, right? So how does that ST segment look like? ST segment of a myocardial infarction looks something like this. So this is the QR wave, and here there is ST segment elevation with T wave inversion is seen. So if you see this ST segment elevation is convex upwards, and we have the name for this, which is called, this is called as Pardy sign, or it looks like a tombstone, right? So it is also called as tombstone pattern. So this is ST segment elevation, which is also associated with T wave inversion. Where is this present? This is actually present in myocardial infarction, right? Now if you see one more important thing here, in acute pericarditis, the main important difference, one more important difference which is important here, is in acute pericarditis, if we have all the lids put in ECG, almost 11 out of 12 lids will have this type of ST elevation. But there is one lid which does not show this elevation, that is AVR. AVR will show reciprocal change. It shows ST segment depression is seen by AVR. So in AVR will also show depression in normal person also. So how do you see this AVR? This in the AVR you will see that there is P wave is inverted and there is inverted saddle shape depression, ST segment depression is seen, and T wave is inverted. This is how you see in AVR. Then if we see the echocardiography, in the echocardiography you will see presence of minimal pericardial effusion is seen, and this also you can do CBNAT study or gene expert can also be done, because here the disease is tuberculosis. We can do either CBNAT or gene expert study can be done, and after that we should give anti-tubercular therapy is given for 6 months. Okay, so this is tubercular pericarditis. So if you see the complications of tubercular pericarditis, this tubercular pericarditis can result in one more disease which is called as constrictive pericarditis. This is actually a sequelae of tubercular pericarditis. So let us now also learn about constrictive pericarditis also, so that this will be done. So let us now learn about constrictive pericarditis. Constrictive pericarditis mainly occurs due to tuberculosis, that is tubercular pericarditis. Here if you see the heart, here we have the tuberculosis. After once it heals, there is deposition of fibrosis in the pericarditis and slowly calcification develops around the heart. Around the heart there is development of calcification. This calcification will limit the filling of the heart. So as a result there is decreased filling of the heart, and whenever the turbulence created by the diastole when it strikes the ventricular surface, this will result in pericardial shudder. I will just show you the picture. See, this is the heart with the, this is the myocardium of the heart. Now there is thick fibrosis and calcification has occurred. Now because of this thick calcification, when the blood comes, it will strike the calcified heart wall, and as a result there is turbulence which is created. The blood will bounce back, and this is heard on auscultation like a pericardial shudder, which is also pericardial shudder. This is seen as a pericardial shudder, or this is seen as pericardial shudder, or we call it also as with one more name, which is called as pericardial shock, or we can also call it as pericardial knock. Where does this pericardial shudder or shock or knot occur? It occurs after the opening snap, and this pericardial shudder is a high pitched sound. If you remember, the pericardial rub which is present, that is a low pitched sound, but this pericardial shudder is a high pitched sound which is heard with diaphragm of the heart. So this is about the tubercular pericarditis and its complication, constrictive pericarditis. Thank you for watching.